Product Wednesday, and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
And on this week's show, we are live
at the world's largest poker tournament outside of Las Vegas. We're at the Rico Arena in Coventry at Goliath.
We're right here.
They've been playing for, I think, a part of 500 and something thousand pounds, so over £500,000.
You sound like an expert.
Yeah, I've been here for the last 8 days doing magic for everybody. It's been great. They're down to like the final 10 people, so now, so I think the winner's going to be going home with something like £72,500.
Awesome.
All for £120 buy-in.
Not too bad at all. Right, first of all, on this week's show, we've got an effect called Fingers by Mickael Chatelin. Fingers is a gimmicked card, no surprise there, from Mickael Chatelin, because he does specialise in producing gimmicks, especially gimmick cards. What do you reckon to the effect when you see it on the trailer?
Well, when Michael's performing it, it is absolutely phenomenal. I mean, it looks like an amazing visual super change, doesn't it?
Yeah, you can't give that card out for examination straight away, so a bit of a drawback with that. But what you do get is an incredibly visual change. You get that moment where you can just snap your fingers and shake it and it can visually change, well, or stroke your hand in front of it and it changes.
I think, here's the thing with this gimmick, you can, if you're going to do it, I think that visual change might lead people down the path that maybe it's a gimmick card. But I think the bit that impresses me the most when Mickael does it is when he's passing his hand over it, and then it looks like it might be a sleight that you're doing. So it then makes it look like you're doing skillful magic,
yeah,
rather than going, you know, rather than
because we were going to do it, and after about half an hour's practice, I don't think I can do it very well. You don't do it very well. We tried to make it look as good as Mickael,
but I did do it better than you.
Yeah, right. We actually looked at some kids on YouTube doing it that put up their own videos, and they seem to be doing it very well indeed. So it's obviously
that we're not very good.
With a little bit of practice, you can actually make this look very, very good. Would you use it though?
Maybe for a video. I don't think it's something that I gig. I mean, I think I've got sleights that I can do which definitely give exactly the same effect as what's happening here, and I'm left clean at the end of them.
I think
well.
Normally with a gimmick normally makes an effect a lot easier. Mm. For me, it doesn't feel easy to actually perform it. It doesn't feel like a natural thing, like just something that's just happening with a flap or something like that. It's not something that's just happening. You have to do a lot more to it to handle this as smoothly as Mickael does it. For that reason, I'm not gonna give it as high a mark as I did for like the Paradox card, which is one of my favourite effects to come out this year. I'm going to give this 74%.
Yeah, it works. I like it when Mickael did it. I liked it when the kids on YouTube did it. I know some people are going to like this. I'm going to give it 71%.
So not a great mark for our first review, but later on we have got a Worker of the Week coming up.
Ooh.
Next up we've got
the Wonder Business Card by the Magic Arp, here's the key, which is how it's said on the thing.
The download. So you get an instructional download with lots of different routines with it using these business cards. You get about 30 business cards in the pack to do it. There's routines with sort of analysing people's drawings. There's stickers, coloured stickers on cards that you can tell. But we're going to demo the basic effect right now. Jamie, can we get it off the sticks?
Wow, we don't do this often anymore. Off the sticks. Okay, I'm going to make a little bit of space just like that. We've got the five.
He's off the sticks now.
We've got a few of these business cards here.
Yeah.
Cards the size of business cards. I'm going to turn my back. And what I want you to do, David, with this pen, is I want you to draw a cross or write your name on one of these. And then, so I don't know which one it is, just turn it this way up, so there's no way I can possibly know.
Right,
which
okay.
One. I'm looking away right now.
I've drawn the cross. Turn it face down.
Turn it face down, and when you've done that, tell me so I can turn back.
I've done it.
I'm looking back, and then just mix the cards up as well. So there's absolutely no way I could possibly know. Give them a shuffle up, mix them up. So not even you know.
I don't know.
Which one it is. And then when you're happy, you can stop. Are you happy?
Yeah.
Perfect, and we're just going to make a little pile down like this. And could you just hold out your hand for me? I'm just going to see. You don't know which one it is, do
you? I don't know which one it is,
no. I'm just going to cast your shadow over these. Okay. I think you go down.
on that one. Can you just turn that over for me?
That is right. Now.
And there's no marks, there's no dots, there's nothing. You can have a look at that card.
There is no marks.
No marks,
cards.
No dots, no nothing. No marks on the cards. Completely 100% examinable under the eye of a microscope. Like that could be examined and you wouldn't find a thing wrong with it. The batteries will recharge themselves. You get a USB port that you attach into the stack that just recharges them. So clever stuff, really. In all seriousness, though, you might be familiar with the method. I'm not going to tell you what the method is, because this isn't like his own invention. This is something that was written in the Tarbell books.
Yes.
It's a very hard gimmick to make that he's made for you. So that's what it is. And it
works.
The
thing is, right, if we'd have been at a magic convention or just chilling out after a gig or something like that, and you took out these blank business card stocks and you said do this and mix them up, honestly, I would have no idea how you did it.
And even when you do know how it's done, it's kind of surprising me every time. I go, oh, I got it right.
Yeah.
And I do get, I've never not got it right. I have got this right every single time.
This would fool magicians.
It.
This would fool magicians. That was not set up. It's not prearranged. Even I don't believe this works, and yet it does. Every single time we do it, it works every single time. I think we need to mention that it comes with ingeniously gimmicked business cards. Here's the main problem with this. If you've got a stack of business cards like this and it was in a nice box and you got like 500 of these ingeniously gimmick cards, I would be going, all right, that's quite a good product. The worst thing about this for me as a product is that you only get 30 of the special cards. And you're going to want to do this quite a bit. You're going to want to repeat it at a gig. It's not the sort of thing where you do it once and it's so special, you know, you're doing it again, you do it once at a gig. You want to do it with lots of people.
Yeah, you don't want to be ordering three of them. If you're doing three gigs a week and you're going to be doing it mixing England, building it into your set, you need more of the cards than that there. That's not fair.
But if you're the sort of person that makes a feature of something, they're doing it once in a longer show, a parlour show or something like that, it's amazing. I don't know how to describe it really apart from that. The one thing I think you struggle with is how to make this into a viable presentation, in that the spectator doesn't know what it is either.
Yeah.
So how are you reading them? It almost is a magic trick, isn't
yeah.
it? Because you're not reading them because they don't know which one it is.
No, they generally don't know. It is just how do you know that?
Yeah.
And what are you going to give it?
It's tricky, you know. I do think I would show somebody this. I would fool a magician with it, but it's not enough for me to use it in a professional working repertoire like the Worker of the Week we've got coming up later. I would give this 77%.
Yeah, again, it works. 75% from me. And next up, we've got Blackbird by Jeff Copeland.
And this is not Jeff Copeland. We've been joined by Clive Wilkins.
Yes.
And Clive, you are a card.
A coin. He is a card. We were at the bar last night. He was such a card, weren't you, Clive?
You are.
But he's not actually a coin. He's a person. Yeah, but he is a coin expert.
You do a bit of this and a bit of this, pulling out the sleeves and that.
Oh,
kind
I like
of...
it all. Yeah,
he's got very clean hands, haven't you?
Yeah. Clean hands.
His hands are cleaner than Michael Vincent's.
So you were very interested in this because you've been working at the casino today with Sean, and when we brought this to review this morning, because we got to the casino nice and early, and you were very interested to see this because you were like, wow, I've heard about this, I'm a coin magician, this is my thing. What's your initial thoughts on this gimmick?
Well, I'm fascinated to find out anything new that comes on the market, because it's going to be of interest to me, right?
Yeah.
And I've looked at this quite closely. It's a fascinating little gizmo. It's really well made. It's a great bit of kit to play around with, but would I use it? No.
Why wouldn't you use it?
Well, because I work professionally.
And what does a professional need? Why doesn't a professional need cool little gizmos like this?
I don't understand. I think you can learn a lot by using cool little gizmos like this, because it makes you think about your routines and it makes you think about how you're working. But ultimately, most people I know of who are professional workers don't use gimmicks like this at all. They go out with their pack of cards, their Sharpie pen and their coins,
right.
And everything's ungaffed.
Okay, well,
and
you're...
There's clever ways in which you can use your body to make things happen without having to have stuff
have
like
you got
that.
One of your dollars there that I could borrow?
Yes.
We could just demonstrate how this works.
One of my French dollars, my 5-franc pieces.
So you have this gimmick actually inside your sleeve this way. We'll put some clips on the screen as well. A coin can go in there and it locks in place. Got quite a clever locking mechanism.
Yeah.
And this is in your sleeve like this.
Yeah.
And through the material of your sleeve, you release the lock, and this will drop out into your sleeve and then
it drops it down into your elbow.
We're not giving anything away there because the trailer is, the creators have put a public trailer.
Yeah, so the motion is you unclip it, you bring your arm up, it drops the coin down into your elbow, and then you just then need to retrieve it how you want.
It works with different size coins as well, obviously the dollars. But you get the extra,
the
half dollars, because you get these extra insert bits that fit inside it. The gimmick, what I want to say, I don't want to detract from the fact that this is made incredibly well. And it works flawlessly and it works perfectly.
But there is a price for it.
I just want to say as well that if you like this, because the trailer's quite open, you're not going to be disappointed with how it actually works. It does work, doesn't it?
It's very, very good.
It works better than I thought it would work. Having we're all there for today's
Steve and Steve tournament. Please make your way back to the tournament area. That's all there for today's Steve and Steve. Please make your way back to the tournament area.
Are you playing?
The tournament is actually going on.
So here's my actual thoughts on this. If I was 14 years old, or if I was new to coin magic, which I was when I was 14, then I would definitely probably like, I need this. This is a gimmick that I need. If I'm going to spend my money, I'm going to spend my money on one of these.
If you're 14 years old, you'd be spending your money, probably knowing you for so long, probably on cigarettes.
Yes, probably. but if I had anything left over, I'd get something like this. But then the problem is, from a professional point of view, like I was saying, I think I can achieve this without that. I think it has to do more. If I was going to wear this, it needs to do more, because I've got one on each arm. The most I can do is produce 2 coins. And once they're out of it, it doesn't do anything else. I can't put the coins back in it. I've not got like 4 coins that I can drop one at a time out of there.
Yeah, precisely.
Let's mention as well that Jeff, he doesn't just explain the gimmick and go, this is how it works, woo, that's it. Jeff is a fabulous magician, a fabulous coin magician.
And
you
great could, on the demo, yeah.
You could learn a lot by watching the whole sort of 3-hour download of Jeff, and I saw some very nice stuff, and it's the sort of stuff that I like to watch, and I'm sure it's the stuff you like to perform.
He's very good.
He's a very, very competent performer. So this takes nothing away from Jeff. It's just our personal preference. This is not something we'd use. It feels a bit clunky to have all these things under your arm.
You wouldn't want that on your
arm.
Sleeves all evening.
And years ago,
that's gonna get...
I used to do a routine that was a coin routine called Circle to the Fourth Dimension. I needed to introduce a big...
I used to do that.
Some people did, and then they leave it behind. That's what happens. It used to produce a big coin. I just used to use a bulldog clip inside my sleeve. And it works. It works just as well as this, even though this is a very cool bit of James Bond kit.
Less is more, ultimately.
Less is more.
Yep.
How much would you give this out of 100?
Out of 100.
Over 90 says you're going to use it, so it's less than 90.
60%,
Sean?
I'm not going to use this, but it does work, and there will be a 14-year-old kid out there or somebody new to magic that will get something out of this.
Or somebody that needs this specific thing to happen when they're just adjusting their sleeve. It's not me, but somebody out there is going to get this. They'll not be disappointed because it's made incredibly well. If you think this could bring something to your coin magic, get it, because it's great. It is good. It's just not for me. 64%.
Yeah, 66% from me.
We're going to say up front that this is getting a Worker of the Week. So Worker of the Week at World Magic Shop, which means if you order this by midnight on Friday, you're going to get Aaron Jones's magicianary position absolutely free. We'll tell you more about that very, very soon. But why is this getting Worker of the Week? Let's describe the effect first of all. It's by Juan Pablo.
It's a magic trick that goes wrong, but in the most spectacular way.
It's a great opener, isn't it?
Oh, it's incredible. I can't wait to do this. I'm not just your mind will tell you it was an opener for Cabaret, but you could certainly use this close up as well, especially for a bigger table or if you've got a bigger crowd of people around you. And I actually can't wait to perform this.
So Jamie, who's behind the camera right now, Jamie has actually done this already. We've got it out of the box within 30 minutes. He's been doing it. He's been performing it. It's a newer version, isn't it, Jamie?
It is, yeah.
A trick that's been out before. But it's the new version, it's the updated version.
And the ending, which is what's so special about
this. That was Jamie's input right there. Yes, yes it is. I was expecting like a, yes, it's different because it's this, it's
I thought he was going to say what I'm just about to say. Okay. I thought he was going to say yes, because Jamie does own the old one, hasn't he?
Yeah.
But the new version has a spectacular, and that finish, where, well, I'm sure you'll see it on the screen, where that happens.
Right, so there's going to be clips phenomenal on the screen, so I'll talk you through it. First of all, you've got the rope in your hands, and then, very visually, it's like one end of the rope passes through your jacket, so now you're holding it in your hand and yet it's going down your sleeves. And then the bit that's inside your jacket seems to pass through your body, so now it's going round your back and coming out of each sleeve. And then just in one motion, you just kind of pull the rope and it just seems to all be there in front. And then at that moment, you could just go straight into another routine, a cut and restored rope, or however you want to use that piece of rope. But there's about three or four bits of magic, very visual bits of magic, that take you completely by surprise, that happen in the space of about 30, 40 seconds.
It's brilliant. It's
just, making this a great opener.
And they look like a camera trick.
Yeah.
It's like stunning, like that is just not possible.
He's got an extra on the DVD where he says about putting it through his neck at the end, but that's not as good. The best way is to do the routine, just go straight into it, three or four stunning changes, and then you're left just with two normal bits of rope. In your hands, you could say, point to a piece of rope and use that piece of rope in a trick, or use both bits of rope.
Or just throw them away and go, because it's basically, you're trying to do this rope trick and it keeps going wrong, and you could throw it away. That's what I do. I throw it away and go, God, sod it, I'm going to do a card trick.
Now, if you had a case or a suitcase or a bigger box, it is possible, isn't it, Jamie? We reckon it's possible to do this in the middle of your act. So you go into a case, you'd need a little bit of cover, you need to cover this area, you need to go into your case or box, children's party or whatever, and not really get anything ready, just kind of put three bits in position very quickly behind your back, then you'd be ready to come out and do the effect. So although you would think about this and think, oh, it's a great opener, you could do it in the middle of your show as well, but not close up because you need that cover. Fair to say?
Fair to say.
Fair to say. In the box, you get some rope to get you started with. You might want to change for your own rope that you use all the time, but the rope in there is standard magician's rope, and you get a very clever gimmick that you wear on your body, which accomplishes the effect.
And it certainly, it doesn't take up much space on you. This isn't a clumpy gimmick. It's something that's going to, it's not going to alter the line of your jacket or clothes in any way.
So, I'm going to give this 93%.
I am going to give this 96% because I know a thing that I'm going to do at the end after that, I can say it's going to get such a good reaction and I can't wait to go do it.
You're going to use it. I'm going to use this. It's a great opener. It's absolutely fantastic. If you order this week from World Magic Shop, remember it's our Worker of the Week this week. You've seen the footage on the screen. You've seen how visual it is. It looks even better in real life, to be honest. If you order it this week, you'll get Aaron Jones's Magicianary position sent absolutely free. On that DVD, you've got effects with coins vanishing out of envelopes. You've got his anniversary salsa, a very commercial
version. I just remembered. I know what you're coming up with next.
Very commercial version of anniversary waltz, and probably the best business card trick giveaway ever, where you tear the corner of your business card, you spin it around, then it restores, twisted and restored, and you give away your business card in this twisted state. Probably the best business card trick giveaway ever. That DVD you get absolutely free, that was filmed at the Lads Convention. Don't forget, Lads is coming up. It's the last Sunday of September. Very, very soon, the initial registration price is ending. It will go up to £20 without a voucher. Right now it's £15 with a £10 voucher, right before we announce our final star lecturer. That's this week's Worker of the Week. That's one of the best products we've seen in a while. It's our first Worker of the Week in a while. And that's it. I'm hurrying because you've got to get back to work.
I've got to go
at the largest poker tournament outside of Las Vegas. But next week, I'll actually be in Las Vegas.
Oh, here we go.
You're not going, are you?
No.
No.
I'm not going because I've got so many gigs on. You two didn't have any gigs on in August, so you're going to go on holiday.
That's because I put the time out 2 years ago. I'm not making this mistake away. We're going to the world's greatest magic convention, aren't we, Jamie?
We are indeed.
We will see you in Las Vegas. If you're going to Las Vegas, we'll be going live on the World Magic Shop Facebook page. So go to World Magic Shop now and click like and notifications, so you need to get notifications. So when we go live, we're going to go and challenge people in the dealer hall. We're going to challenge them
to show us
their best tricks. Oh. And hopefully Juan Pablo will be there and he'll show us this one live and in person. If not, we'll definitely see some other things, and we'll be spending some time with superstar magicians, and you will only see that live on the World Magic Shop Facebook page. Until then, and next time on the Wizard Product Review, I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
See you next time. Woo!